In this video, we'll cover the process of setting up cameras and exporting 3D views. By default, every project already has cameras placed automatically by the program, but we also have user cameras that allow us to save our own views. Cameras can be added and adjusted in 2D using the Camera tool, or in 3D via the Camera Properties tab of the Inspector. In this tab of the Inspector, we have all our predefined cameras, user cameras, and movie tracks. We can rename our user cameras by just double-clicking on them and typing in a new name. Now, once we select the user camera, we can see that a translucent icon appears in the top right corner of the 3D view. The same icon appears when we add a new camera, and what this means is that we're changing the position of our camera as opposed to just walking around our interior. We may set now our point of view and resume the regular walk-around mode by pressing Escape or clicking on any point in the 3D view. If we're happy with our camera, we should probably lock it, and we can do that in the project tree. Here we need to click the lock icon next to our camera. Once we do that, we can select our camera, but we can't change any of its properties, on purpose or by accident. Also, take note that clicking on a camera in this list and pressing spacebar brings up the camera preview window. Now let's go ahead and take a look at how Live Home 3D exports these 3D views to the picture file that we can send out to our friends or family. To do that, we need to select a camera, then click Export 3D View in the Inspector, or use the Share Export to File option in the toolbar. In the Export dialog, let's select the destination, the format, and the resolution. Note that the Pro Edition allows us to export to a larger resolution and even enter in a custom size. After that, we need to set the quality. Then the program exports the view and offers us to open it in preview. Well, that basically wraps it up for 3D views and panoramas.